LastPass is a password management application that allows you to securely store, generate, and share passwords and more. In this demo, I'll be giving you an overview of the key features of the platform. So let's dive in. Now, when you first set up your LastPass account or you're in your vault, you'll see a pop-up about a LastPass browser extension. This is something that you'll want to install because it gives you easy access to a lot of the features of LastPass. So to do this, you can just click Install Now in your top banner, or you can go to your relevant browser app store and just download it through there. And now you can see that the extension has been added at the top here. So here we're in our main vault and you can see that I haven't added any passwords yet. When you start, you can either import all your passwords or you can add them manually one by one. So if I click that, you'll see the option to add a password. There are some other options, but I'll go through these in a bit. In addition to adding passwords manually, the browser extension will also prompt you to add a password every time you log into an account that it doesn't have stored in the vault or when you set up a new account. So I will show you an example of the browser pop-up now. So we're going to log into our Twitter account. And what you can see here is this little pop-up has appeared. So it's given you the site that you're on, the username, and you can either choose not to add the password or you can choose to add it straight away. So if I press add, that says all set. And if I go back to my vault, you'll see a folder here called social, and there is the Twitter login details. And to show you what that's like when you have got the password stored in your vault, if I go back to the login page, you can see there's autofilled the password. If it hasn't, you can also use this drop down. Occasionally, if you have multiple accounts, there'll be multiple listings here. So you can just click on that. It will fill the credentials and then you can log in. Now, whilst we're talking about the browser extension, I will show you a few other features included in it. So if we use the drop down on the browser extension, there is a search function. That means that you can just search for credentials or anything else that you have stored without having to actually go into your vault. You can also quick access your vault here, so you don't have to use your browser to search for LastPass and then open up the vault that way. You can just go to your extension and click Open My Vault and that will open it in a new tab. You have a Recently Used section, so you can see all the passwords that you have recently accessed. There's also an All Items, so you can go in and you can search for passwords, you can search for any notes you have saved, and so on. You can also manually add an item here. So if you want to add a password here, then you can do so and that will open a pop-up like this. You can also generate a secure password. Now this is a really handy feature. So if, for example, you can't think of a password or you just want to use something completely random that no one could ever guess, you can ask LastPass to generate this for you. And obviously you don't have to remember it because it will be stored in your account. So it will show you the password and you can refresh this if you want to change it to something different. You can copy it. You can also adjust the length of the password. So if there's a minimum requirement, then you can go all the way up to 100 characters if you really want to. There are also some advanced options. So you can disallow certain character types. So you could take off numbers, you could add symbols to it. You can also add a minimum value, so a minimum number of numbers that you must include. So if you want to have 6 numbers in the password, then you can do that. So there's a whole bunch of features there for you to play with. Security dashboard is something we'll go through a bit later on. Same with account options, but you can see you can quick access your account options here. So essentially this browser extension is like a miniature version of LastPass. You can access all the same things, but just a much quicker way of doing it. So now we're back in the vault, I've added a few more passwords. Now I mentioned earlier about manually adding passwords. Now that I have added a few, the way to add more passwords is using this little red plus button in the corner. So you can press that and it will bring up the password addition options. And now I've added a few passwords. You can actually see next to this one, I have got a little red icon. And this is a warning icon to show that your password is at risk. And this might be because it has been reused, it's been compromised, it's too weak, and so on. So that's a really good thing to look out for on LastPass. And you can also see that when I'm hovered over an item, there are some options. So the big one here is this launch button, and this will essentially open the site on another tab. So when you add a new site, you add the login URL with it. This launch button does vary though, depending on what you have stored. So as we mentioned earlier, you don't just store passwords. So if you stored a note, it would give you an edit button instead. You can also see this little tick box in the corner. When ticking this, it gives you an actions button at the top here. So it gives you a few different options such as edit, delete, or share your password. If you were then to tick multiple options in the bowl, it would change these actions. And this is handy if, for example, you want to mass delete or move multiple items into a folder. Hovered over again, you can see this little spanner here. Clicking this opens the password edit box. And this is where you'll see what that red warning sign means. And that means that you're able to rectify it. And it will give you the steps to do this. And when you're in this edit box, you can change anything in here. So you can change the URL for where you want to launch to. You can change the name of the site. You can change the folder, the username, the password. You can also add one-time passwords, notes. You can also require your master password reprompt as well if you want to fill it in. And you can also untick the autofill. So if you don't want it to automatically fill your credentials, you want to manually do that, you can do that as well. There are also some options down here. So you've got the option to favorite the password, to share it, delete it, or edit it. And back over to this item, you've got the option to delete with the little bin icon here. So if you want to delete that, you can. And in the middle of the edit and the delete is the share button. And this gives you the option to share your password securely. Now, typically we say don't share passwords. However, let's say you work in the marketing department and you want to share access to a company social account. This would be a good way to do it. So we've opened up the share box. And all you have to do is type in your recipient email associated with their LastPass account. To keep things extra secure, LastPass leave the allow recipient to view password box unticked. So that means that essentially you can share the login credentials with them, but they can't actually see the password. So they'll still be able to log in, but they just won't be able to edit or view the password. So if you do want them to be able to see the password, you can tick that to allow them to do it. And then you would just press the share button. They would get an email to accept that, and then it would appear in their vault. Another thing you can do in terms of sharing is share whole folders. So if we hover over the red plus button, there is the option to add new folders, so you can add folders as you please. LastPass does also automatically create you some, so you can see it's put Twitter under social and it's put Amazon under shopping. So you can right click on this folder and you can share. And you can see here that it tells you that each recipient of this share folder will gain access to anything it contains. So anything additional you add to that folder, they will have access to as well. It's not just the existing items. So you'd hit create, and then you can see it's labeled here as a shared folder. And then when you right click on it again, you can see the option to manage folder. And that's where you can invite people, and you can also give them different permissions. So you can see that I'm the administrator, but if we added more people, we could give them read-only options, you could hide passwords from them. You can also see if they've accepted the invitation or not. Now, as we mentioned earlier, when we went to add a password, there were some different options. So you've got password, secure note, address, payment card, and bank account. There are also more items, so you have everything from driving license, social security number. You can put server information in here, or you can also add a custom type as well. Each item has different questions based on what you are adding. So if you go into your passport, it will ask you for information relating to your passport. You can also add attachments. So if you wanted to upload a photo of your passport, you can do that. If we go into your bank account, you can see it asks for bank details. Your address option will give you address details and so on. A few other things to show you in the main vault. So you've got some buttons up here. So this first one collapses all of your folders or expands them all. You can also do this individually on each one. This button up here gives you a compact view. So it just gives you a smaller view of everything, or you can make it big again. It's entirely up to you. You can also change your viewing style. So if you prefer a grid, you can leave it on grid view, or you can also list all of your passwords here. And you can also rearrange the folders. So you can sort by folder names, you can also sort by item names, and you can sort by the most recent login details that you have used. Over on the far left here, you have your toolbar. So you can collapse this when you're using the vault, or you can maximize it. You can opt to see certain items. So you can see at the moment we're viewing all items, but you can just select your passwords. You can just select your notes, your addresses, payment cards, and bank account. Further down, as we mentioned earlier, you have your security dashboard. And this is a very handy tool to check on regularly. It will tell me how many passwords you have at risk. It's also where you can manage multi-factor authentication on your accounts. If your company doesn't force you to use MFA on your LastPass account, we would recommend you enable it as soon as possible. Just imagine someone getting into your LastPass account because they guessed your master password. And you can also enable dark web monitoring on your accounts as well. Below security dashboard, you have your account benefits. So it's always worth noting that with LastPass for Business, you also get a free LastPass family account to use. Next down, you have your sharing center, and this is where you can see all the shared folders that you have, any items that you have shared with other people, and items that they have shared with you. You then have your account settings. So this is useful if you want to change your master password or perhaps your reminder for that. And you can also see multi-factor authentication options. So you can see that I've got Microsoft Authenticator enabled on my account. You can see trusted devices and so on. And then in the advanced options, there are a few handy features in here actually. So one of them is account history. And this will show you where you've used LastPass to log into sites recently. And in advanced options, you can also see deleted items. So any deleted items will stay in here for 30 days before being permanently deleted. Advanced options is also another way to generate secure passwords over the browser extension. So that is an overview of LastPass.